Oh, I've been a geek from a very early age. When I was, I think, about 12, my parents, for my birthday, they bought me a programmable calculator, and they hid it away waiting for my birthday. But I found out that they bought it, and I found out where it was, and so at night, when they were asleep, I would crawl out of bed and go to the closet where they'd hidden it away and open it and play with it and learn to program. That's when I first learned to program. And then, of course, I'd wrap it back up and put it back away so that they wouldn't know that I'd been doing this. And then when it came to learning about the brain, it was like it turned out to be the most incredible, complicated, huge programmable calculator ever. So it's the same problem, except it's so much more interesting and complicated. I think a lot of neuroscientists get into it because it's us. It's really about trying to understand what makes us tick. There's 10 billion neurons in a typical human brain. Each of those, on average, connects to about 1,000 others. So that's 10 to the 14 synapses, 10 to the 14 connections. We always say that's more stars than there are in the known universe. One of the reasons that I chose to come to Princeton was because so many of my heroes are here at Princeton. For example, John Hopfield. I credit John with being the person that taught me how to think. David Tank, who has developed some of the most advanced technologies that we use to study the brain and is still doing so in a very exciting way. And I knew, of course, that the students were excellent. That was one of the things that brought me here. It was a delight how intelligent and how motivated and how serious about the work a lot of the students can be. Because the brain is so crazily complicated and because it works at so many levels, you can start studying the brain at the level of a single neuron, or you can study it at the level of a few tens of neurons, or you can study it at the level of thousands of neurons, or you can study it at the level of behavior and billions of neurons. Those are many different ways to look at it and require many different ways of thinking. Some of them require molecular biology, some of them require psychology, some of them require computer science. The brain, because of its nature, requires interdisciplinary cross-level thinking to make the advances beyond what we know now. It's about exchanging ideas, no matter which department you're in. And that has been a big part of what promotes neuroscience here at Princeton and what makes me think, oh, we're really going to do something special here. Understanding how the brain works will have impact on philosophy, will have impact on engineering, will have impact on health. And here at Princeton, we're on the cusp of producing those interdisciplinary links right now. The best part about being here, the stellar intellects that you're surrounded by, the challenge that provides. There are a lot of people here that are smarter than I am. That's where I want to be.